Enter when ready.
I wanted to do a video on my sound system for my television and other things. It's a 42-inch Toshiba TV that I bought from Best Buy. Cheap. I think it's like $200 maybe or less. The reason I got a 42-inch was because it fits in this entertainment center, and I know it is antiquated, and I'll be getting rid of it fairly soon and getting a bigger TV, but for now this is what I got here. And up at the top you can see my homemade 4-bay bow tie antenna for HD over the air. So what I have, everything I have is really pretty cheap. So this is doing sound on the cheap. And to me, it's not a surround sound system or anything, but it works very well for me. And it's cheap. So let's start off with, I have the speakers. So this is a floor tower speaker, and it is a Pioneer with a port at the bottom. And we have another one over here. And I bought these from Costco probably like 10 years ago for a ridiculously low price. Forget what it was. It was probably like $50 or something. No, maybe a little bit more. Maybe like $70, something like that. And I also have this Jensen center channel speaker, which I don't use anymore because I don't have an amplifier, a 5.1 amplifier, or any amplifier that has a center channel in it anymore. So I don't use it. It's just sitting up here because it's a good place to store it, I guess. But so these big floor standing speakers provide all the bass that I would need. And then I got these super cheap. I think these were like $20 for a pair of these 3.5 speakers. I have them on both sides here. And the thing is about these is they only, you know, give you the highs. So it's kind of a nice compliment to these speakers, which give you basically only the bass. And so the way that these are connected is through a speaker box, and the speaker box is over here. And so number one here is the floor standing speakers. These are the two small high tweeters. And number four I have that go to two speakers out on my back porch that the house is pre-wired for speakers. So here's there's the terminal that goes out to the speakers that come out through the ceiling. And I have two outdoor weather-resistant speakers connected to that. And they were cheap, too. I got those on Amazon for like $30. Cheapest outdoor speakers you can get, which are halfway decent. The next step up from that would be like about a $80 set of Yamahas, and then you could go up again for like $120 for, I think, a set of Piles. I'm not sure exactly, but I don't use my porch all that much, so You know, they sound good enough, if you ask me. My porch is covered, so, and they're up, hanging from the ceiling, so they don't really get any moisture. The only thing that really is going to degrade those speakers is humidity. But, so, yeah, if I want to put, I can put all speakers on, so the indoor speakers and the outside, and they'll all work. Disregard this box, which is actually a subwoofer. It's 15 inch, there's a 15 inch speaker in this, and it's made by a company called DBX. Hopefully you can see that. DBX. That is a company that I'm not sure if DAC, there used to be a company called DAK, DAC, and it was a mail order company that sold all kinds of electronic gear. A lot of it was audio stuff. And so you could buy this subwoofer, and they also sold an amplifier for this subwoofer, which I didn't buy. I just got the subwoofer, and in the back there's a block isolator, whatever you call it, that you send the speaker outputs from your receiver or your amplifier into that, and then the speakers then get connected to the block that's on the back of this. And I've had this connected. I used to use it a lot with a Pioneer receiver that I had that had like a super bass button on it. And this thing is amazing for like not having an actual subwoofer amp, just putting it through the regular receiver's amp. With the super bass on it, that's all you needed. But I don't have that. I don't use that receiver anymore. I replaced it because it's just really old. I have two Pioneer receivers, and both of them are really old. And they're just kind of worn out. Probably. There could be capacitors that are drying up in it or whatever. But plus they use a lot of energy and that kind of stuff. So what I did was I got rid of that Pioneer receiver that used to be right in this shelf. It took up the whole shelf. And I replaced it with this, which is this Lapi Class T amplifier. Now the reason I went with this is I had bought one a couple of years ago, and I've been using it ever since for a different application, and I was really, really impressed with it. This thing only costs like $30, and a Class T chip. I think it's made by Texas Instruments, but it's super, super clean. For $30, this little thing 10, 15 years ago, to get this clear of an amplifier, you would have had to spend thousands of dollars. And now you can get it for $30. I think this thing is only like 20 watts. I'm not exactly sure anymore, forget. But it has all the power I need to power the TV. I have a Alexa dot connected up. I have this DVD player, which the DVD player and this Roku right here, they all go through the TV. So the TV comes down into this audio video switch, which I don't use for video. I only use it for audio. So I have the TV is number one. So if I want to watch the DVD or the Roku or the TV over the air, I don't have to press any other button. It just stays on one. But if I want to use my Roku, or not my Roku, my Alexa, I press 2. And then I also have a 10-foot cable, which has a 3.5 millimeter on the other end, and it's behind, it's right here. You can see it kind of coiled up over there. So if I want to just plug that into my phone and play music from my phone, I can switch to that, and that'll put that cable connected to my phone into this amp, into my speakers. This amp has treble and bass adjustment, and then if you want to use those two, you have to press that little button in. I have it out because with those not in the circuit, I think it sounds fine with the stuff that, you know, the video or the audio that comes out of it. So I'm not really worried about adding extra bass and all that stuff. So I just have it out of the circuit. The thing about these little amps, you know, they come with a power supply, but what you might want to do is what I did. You know, amplifiers, the more amperage they have, the better. You know, if you give it more amps or more power than it needs, that's fine. It's not going to get as hot, and it's going to be more efficient. And I can leave this thing on all the time. That's the thing, is I don't really shut this off. When I shut the TV off or whatever, I just leave it on. And I can't even tell it's on. There's no heat whatsoever. It's not even warm. And this thing has no ventilation. This is all aluminum, the whole case. And there's no opening. There's no heat sink on the back or anything. It's amazing. But it comes with a small power supply. So what I did was I changed it out. I just ordered basically these surplus power supplies, which are old printer power supplies. You can get them for like, you know, $4 or $5 each. And I think it's about double what the amplifier that comes with this amp with. And it just so happens that the pinout on the plugs are exact. So, and the voltage is exact that this system takes. So you just got to make sure when you buy one, and I've bought a couple now, and you know, they don't get hot. The amp doesn't get hot. It's just better to have a little bit more power to the amp. You want the amp to have all the power it would ever need in all situations. So, and I think those, just if you buy one, just make absolutely sure that you double and triple check the pin out on the power supply with the pin in on the amp, so that, you know, the center is positive, the outside is negative, or vice versa. I don't remember. It's been a while since I bought this. So it's going to be that either the center is positive or the center is negative. I don't remember. Just double check, triple check. Because if you plug it in and the polarity is incorrect, I think you're going to do damage to the amp. So just make sure the voltage of the power supply you buy is correct as well. It's not hard to do, to find out the pin configuration and the voltage that it takes. Not a big deal. Simple thing to do. So I would suggest that. And then down here I have, this is an old, ancient 5-disc CD player. This was a big deal back in the day because it had a remote, and you could switch between using the remote between 5 different discs, and you could skip tracks and all that stuff. So that was pretty big deal. I'm not sure if this even works anymore. And then I also have this, which is a Pioneer dual cassette deck And this is ancient as well. Back in the day, it was very important that you had a dual cassette deck because copying cassettes was a big deal. It was something that everyone did pretty much. That's why every, you know, portable boombox generally came with a dual cassette deck. But this I don't use. This isn't hooked up. This is not hooked up. I don't use either of those anymore. But I keep them here because I don't want to get rid of them for some reason. I just think they're cool. And I don't, especially this old cassette deck. I used to use this a lot, and I have lots of fond memories of using this. Same with this. And so I don't want to get rid of them or sell them for whatever reason. This is my DVD player. It's just a cheap Toshiba, but it works great. That's all I kind of, it's not a Blu-ray or anything. I don't buy Blu-rays anyways because I'm mostly stream. I don't really watch DVDs either, but I do have, you know, a pretty decent collection of DVDs. So I still have that. Let's see. Other than that, I also have this. This is a little Bluetooth amplifier. And this was cheap too. I got it on Amazon, and I think it was like maybe a little over 20 bucks, I think. And these are the speaker outputs, the speaker wire outputs, and you just, what I had it connected to this speaker box, and that way what I could do is you turn this on, it's powered by a power adapter. You don't use batteries with this, so you don't have to worry about changing batteries or anything like you would with a Bluetooth speaker. But so this would go into this speaker box, then I could plug in or press the button for the outdoor speakers, and then I could be on my porch and play music via Bluetooth with my phone, and or anyone else who had a phone, you know, could just connect to it as well and play their music if they wanted. So it's pretty cool. I have it disconnected because I was using it for something else for a while. But yeah, it's a very clean amp as well. And it has a lot of power, more than I would ever need on those speakers out there. And the cool thing, though, is you can control the volume with your phone. So, and also what I do is I have this radio over here with that 3.5 millimeter plug in it, and I strip the other end and put it into one side of the speaker. So one speaker is connected to this radio, and then I have this tuned to an FM station, which is all talk radio all the time. That's all they do. And so if you put it on a fairly low volume and it just plays out of one speaker on my back porch, at night, if somebody comes walking around the backyard or whatever, they're going to hear voices, and those voices like bounce off the neighbor's walls and things like that, and you can't really tell where it's coming from, especially at night, because you're not going to see the speakers. And I went out to the back one night, and I forgot that I had this, and I heard it, and I was actually thinking, where are those people who are talking? There's somebody out here. And then I remembered that it was my radio, so it fooled me. You know, it would fool, I think, someone who was, you know, lurking around for nefarious reasons. You know, it may not fool them, but if it does, you know, it's a shot, and they might just move on if they hear that, because they're, you know, it's dark, they don't see where someone might be standing and talking or whatever. So I think it's probably fairly effective or a deterrent, maybe. I don't know. That's just my idea. And I'm not sure if, you know, it would work, but so that's pretty much all I got for this video. So I hope that maybe this would give you some ideas for your own. This is very cheap. This, everything I did is on the cheap. But it sounds really good. So if I turn on the sound, very clear.
Healy was right. Captain Cooley had assigned Dan the Drake. Everything from petty vandalism in base housing to finding Admiral Matheson's missing dog. Putting Dan on this stuff was like making McGarrett the meter maid on Waikiki. But one of these routine cases had somehow gotten Dan killed. I'd know which one when I saw it. Don't ask me how, I just knew I would.
Probably not the best audio to demonstrate, but that's what I got on the TV right now. All right, so that's it.